Yes, God. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. Thank you for this day, God. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this day. Glory, 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 glory. Glory, glory, glory. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Glory. Glory to Jesus. Glory to Jesus. There is none like you, God. None like you. None like you. Glory to God. Glory to God. Oh, thank you, Jesus, for another day. I'm just sharing the broadcast as you come on, share the broadcast, share the grace, glory to God, glory to God. Share it with your friends and share it in your groups. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you, God bless you. I'm going to be praying for you today. I'm going to be reading the word of God and we're going to be talking about a sound mind. Glory to Jesus. Glory to Jesus. Share, share, share the broadcast. Share the broadcast. Share the grace. Share, share, share. Share. Glory to God. Glory to God. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. I'm just sharing the broadcast in the groups. So if you could, when you come on, share the broadcast. Yes, with your friends and in your groups. Glory to God. I thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. God is so good. Oh, I thank him. I praise him. There is none like him. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Just sharing the broadcast in the groups and letting everybody join the broadcast. Letting everybody join the broadcast. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hey, God bless you. God bless everybody. Yeah, hey, Dennis. Hey, 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 Apostle John. Glory to God. God bless everyone. Ah, Pastor, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you so much for joining the broadcast, everybody. As you come on, share the broadcast. Share the grace. Share the grace. Share the grace. Ah, my niece Moni is on here. God bless you guys. God bless you. I'm just waiting for people to come on and Mark and everybody. Thank you so much, Leroy. Thank you so much for joining the broadcast. Prophetess Debbie Wilson here. Glory to God. God gave me a word today and I'm going to come on and present that. Oh, I just thank God. I just thank God. You know, it's about the obedience to the Father and about the obedience to the Holy Ghost. You know, I was going to go to like one of my exercise classes, my Zumba class, but God said, no, no, it's about the Spirit today. So that's what I'm doing. I'm going to be reading the Word of God as well. I'm going to be taking prayer requests. Yes, God bless you. Amen. As you come on, share the broadcast. Share the broadcast with your friends. Share it in your groups and you can put it on as a watch party. My ministry is Sanctuary of Love International Ministries. It's a 501c3 organization, but my local assembly here where I live is New Creation Church of God. God bless you, David. Thank you for joining. And my pastor is Pastor Herbert Banks, and he was on the broadcast. And so pump those hearts and likes so I can see if everything is working correctly. If you want to be a part of the broadcast, I can definitely let you be a part of the broadcast. Jackie, thank you for joining. Yes, and I'm taking prayer requests. So you can type your prayer requests into the broadcast, and I'm praying for you as well. But you know, we're operating on a battlefield. I've also been reading that book, The Battlefield of the Mind, and God has been talking to me about the strongholds of the mind. You know, the way that we've been socialized in this life, in this world, and the things that we have on our mind. You know, a stronghold is something that you can want to release or distinguish. This is more part of a like a deliverance series as well, but it can come back if you don't continue to pray about that thing. You know, even as Christians, God bless you. Thank you for joining. We still have strongholds. A majority, there's a lot of Christians that have issues with their mind. And what I'm talking about just the correct thinking. You know, that the mind of Christ is what we look forward to, you know, and that's based on the word of God. But I'm saying even us, you know, people that are, you know, Bible readers, Holy Ghost filled, and all the things, living the life that we believe is the best life so that we can have eternal life through Christ Jesus, we still have some things in our heads that we got from mama, daddy, or that we got from, you know, the culture we're living in or the church community, not like a particular church, but just growing up in the church, you know, things that we need to, that are not like the mind of Christ. God bless you, Troy. Thank you for joining. Hey, friend. God bless you. Hey, everybody, as you come on, share this broadcast, share the grace. Yes, 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 Bismarck, yes. You know, because somebody else may need to hear about this. You know, we don't always have time to address everything on a Sunday morning or, you know, things such as that. But we need to have the mind of Christ, and we get that by reading the word of God. And so I'm taking prayer requests as well during this broadcast. Yes, 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 yes. Strongholds. Yes. So if you have a prayer request, you can type that into this broadcast, and you can also friend me here on Facebook. I do take prayer requests via Facebook Messenger. You just type in your request and I follow up on those. If you need me to contact you, just leave me a message. But I want to let you know, when I'm coming on to Facebook, I'm coming on to do the work of the Lord. So I don't have time to do the hi, how are yous and all that. Just know I love you all with the love of the Lord. But you know, when you have a lot of followers and things such as that, you know, and you're here for a specific purpose, please don't feel like I'm ignoring you or being antisocial. It's just I have to keep my focus. I have to keep my mind stayed on the things of God and things of the spiritual realm. And a lot of times I'm studying or I'm communing with God, and you know, you got things going on. So yeah, so it's important to keep our mind on God, and that we have to stay strong. And then, you know, we have to deliver. We have to be delivered from the things that we've learned that are not of God, from the systems of this world that are in place that are not of God. Racism is not of God. Sexism is not of God. Any ism, schism is not from God, you know? And so these are all strongholds. Hey, Exodus, William. Hey, everybody. Thank you for joining. Thank you for joining. Yes. And if you'd like to be a part of the broadcast, just send me a signal. If you have a prayer request, I'm taking prayer requests at this time. You know, so, but I'm really wanting to talk about, we're going to look at what it says in God's word. I'm just waiting for people to join the broadcast. You know, what it says about these strongholds that we have in our mind. Basically, the strongholds are demons. They are demons that have, or spirits, however you want to look at it, that we've acquired from this life. Things that we think it's the right way to do things, or the right way to look, or the right way to be, or the, you know, things that, but in the end, they harm us because they take us away from the word of God. They take us into the flesh instead of the things of the spiritual realm. So God is so good. Oh, yes, yes, Jeremiah. Oh, God bless you. God bless you. Thank you so much. Hey, remember to share this broadcast. Share. I want as many people to hear about this as possible, because we're struggling a lot of times as Christians or just people in general. We think we're supposed to, you know, we hear the word every Sunday, or I mean, a lot of us are studying the word during the week or every day and whatever, but we're still having to renew our minds daily because of the things of this life, because our spirit man, you know, the flesh wars against the spirit man. God bless you. Yes, God bless you. Hey, and if this is your first time, Yes. If this is your first time that's going through catching my broadcast, let me know and let me know where you're watching me from. God is so good. Hey, and share this broadcast. Share the grace. Share the grace. Share the grace. God, this is my ministry. It's on social media at this point. And, you know, God has plans for me. I would like to, you know, do some speaking engagements and whatever God has in store for me. I'm just going by the word of God and the things of God, and I'm coming against, in the spiritual realm, the strongholds of our minds, of minds that are not like God. That's anything that you have in your mind that's a stronghold that's not like what it says in the word of God. That is from the satanic realm, the demonic realm, and it's not there to assist you, but to harm you, to keep you stagnant, to keep you focused on the wrong things, you know, to bring on the spirit of pride, or to have us think of ourselves more highly than we should. And that's not of God. That is not of God. Amen. Amen. Oh, God is so good. Yeah, so I'm just, you know, if you have a prayer request, bring that forth. Bring that forth. Bring that forth. Yes, you know, it's a process, though. You know, the renewal of our mind is a process. It's a process. It's not something that we acquire overnight. You know, there's so many things. It's almost like we have garbage in our heads, you know, from this world, from this life. You know, the flesh is worn against the spirit, man. So we have to clean out our minds. We have to clear our minds. We have to renew our minds daily by the word of God. And we have to renew our minds and say, wait, that's you. You got to kind of know, is this you speaking to me, devil? God says in his word, my sheep know my voice. So when you're hearing things, or things are coming across to you that you know is from the demonic realm, you have to say, get out of my head, devil. Get out of my life. Be removed. Be removed. You have no place here. That is not of God. Those thoughts are not of God. Those systems are not of God. You know, those things are not of God. So everything we learned in this life, we've got to renew our minds and to take on the mind of Christ. Yes. Amen. 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 You know, that's our priority. It's about God. It's not about us, but it's about the mind of Christ. God bless you. God bless you, Michelle. Thank you for joining, everybody. If I miss you, Thandi, God bless you. Oh, there's Thandi. Yeah, and if this is your first time, let me know where you're watching me from. I'm here in the United States. Yeah, so, you know, I love the World Wide Web because it's international, and it's showing that the Spirit of God. Hi, Michael. Yeah, it's flowing worldwide. That spirit knows no boundaries, knows no miles, knows, you know, doesn't know distance, doesn't know, it just moves. It just moves. And that's what I'm here today, is to move some things in the spiritual realm, you know, so that we can continue to walk in the plan that God has for your life. I'm here to pray for you. God bless you. God bless you, Prophet Moses. God bless you. God bless you, each and every one of you. This is your first time? Let me know where you're watching me from. Yes, God bless you. Yes. And if not, you know, just let me know. I just like to see where everybody is coming from. But God is so good. God's been talking to me about the strongholds of the mind. Our mind, we've got to renew our mind daily. We've got to die to ourselves daily. And I'm going to be reading the word of God and taking your prayer requests as well. I am here for you. God bless you, California. Oh, okay. It's warm there. It's just starting to get about. I'm here in Michigan. It's just starting to get about in the 70s here. So I'm happy about that. Ah, first time listening. Oh, Houston, got family in Texas. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you all for being here today. I just want to be used by by God. I'm here to pray for you. Read the word of God and just talk about this stronghold of the minds is coming from the satanic realm. Don't believe the things that you see. You know, you have to guard your mind even television, some TV programs, some things that people say, some people that are calling you over the phone and just rattling in your mind that, you know, you can get that into your spirit. So you have to be so careful. Yes, Brittany, God bless you. God bless you. Oh, yeah. So you have to be so careful with your mind these days. Also, the enemy wants to put doubt in our minds that if God has called you to something, you can't do that. How you gonna do that? You don't look like the type of person that would be in that category or in that position, or they're not gonna let you do that. You know, all kinds of things. You have to trust the voice of God. And the only way that we know to trust that voice of God is by getting into his word, by praying with him, by communing with him, by trusting him. Yes, God is so good. Hey, share the broadcast as you come on. Prophetess Debbie Wilson here. Sanctuary of Love International Ministries is my ministry. Yes, God is so good. But God is faithful. God doesn't deal in the negative. He's always telling us that we can do more than we could ever imagine. He's not categorizing people and saying, oh, because you're a woman, you can do this. Or if you're a man, you can do this. If you're black, you can do this. Or if you can't do this because of. And all those schisms and isms that we've learned in this life, those are all strongholds. And I pray right now in the mighty name of Jesus, God, that any stronghold that's in the minds of anybody that will catch this on replay or that is on this broadcast right now, God, that they would be removed in the name of Jesus. I come against the spirit of doubt right now in the name of Jesus, God. I come against the spirit of racism, any kind of ism, God. I come against that right now. Let the Holy Ghost fire burn that and send that back to where it goes, God. God, we close the door in the demonic realm, God, when it comes to strongholds of our mind. We don't open the door, God, for the demonic realm to enter, God. We close it right now in your mighty name. Oh, yes, God. Yes, God. Blessings to you as well, Brittany. Blessings, Brittany. First timer. God bless you. I'm just here to pray for you today if you have a prayer request and talk about this thing of strongholds, because we need deliverance even as Christians. And we love God. We know God loves us. We know we have eternal life through Christ Jesus. But there's a whole lot going on in between that. You know what I mean? If we renew our minds, we don't open up the door to witchcraft or manipulation or things such as that, that are all a part of this mind. There's a lot going on. There's a whole world in there. There's a whole world in there that needs to be cleansed by the Holy Ghost fire. Oh, God, I thank you. I know that God gave me this, told me to come on this broadcast for a particular reason. Share the grace, guys. Share the grace. Share the grace. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost fire. The spirit wins no matter what battles we have in the flesh, you know, but it's a process. It's a process when we've got to renew our minds daily, die to ourselves daily. And we've got to be honest and repent. If there are things in our mind that we know are not like God, we need to bring that to God, to repent and just to do better and go forth. Because, you know, God's not going to hold anything against us. He created us. He knows us. He knows the areas we're struggling in. But we've got to renew our mind. We got to let it go. We've got not to do things that we know that God's not wanting us to do, you know, to create stumbling blocks for people. Yes, yes, ma'am. Yes, yes. Oh, doubt. Yeah, that doubt. God, I come against, we pray against the spirit of doubt right now in the name of Jesus, God. We know that you have not given us doubt or any of those things. You haven't given us fear. You haven't given us, those are all negative things from the satanic realm, God. You want us to walk boldly. You want us to walk strongly. You want us to believe confidently. You want us to have the faith in you, God, that can only come from reading the word and communing with you and praying to you. He wants us to just keep the faith, to keep going. If God has given you something to do in this life, do it. Go forth. No matter whatever criticisms you receive, no matter that, you know, if you're blocked out of entry into things, God will make a way. Trust God. Believe in God. Yes, He'll never leave you or forsake you. He'll never leave you or forsake you. Oh, God, I'm praying against that spirit of doubt. If anybody catches this on replay or if a part of this broadcast, God, increase their faith, God. Give them the strength that goes beyond all understanding, God, to know that you are with them no matter what they're going to, so that they can stay on the path and not be distracted, God, so that they can continue to do the things that you have called them to do in this life, God. Be with them. Go before them. Stand by them. It is so. It is written. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Yeah. Amen. Amen. Go forth, everybody. Don't let that spirit of doubt, you know, let it be removed. It has no place in our lives. You know, it says, like in Ephesians 6 and 12, it says, "For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, and against the rulers," it says, "of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places." So we're not wrestling against the flesh. We got the victory. We have eternal life. We win. We know all this. But a lot of times there's spiritual battles because of this life, this world that we live in, the things that we're taught, the things that happen, politics and all this nepotism and you know, and just all kinds of things that's going on in this life. I know you read the news and I know you've experienced many things in this life that are not like God. That's why we had to renew our minds, you know, because there's some sacrifices that we're going to have to make. You know, because a lot of times you're going to, the enemy's going to want you to compromise your value system or compromise what you know about God to get higher in this life. To, you know, a lot of times we put our own needs before the needs of God. We put our selfish desires before the things that God is telling us to do. Because a lot of times God, amen, 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 amen. God bless you. God bless you, Alice. Yes, God bless you, everybody. You know, he wants us to compromise our value system and say, you know, I can get this, you know, from this person. If I do this a certain way, and if I act a certain way, I'll be received. And, you know, we don't need to compromise our values. Continue to share the broadcast, everybody. Once you've shared the broadcast, let me know you've shared. And if you want to be a part of this broadcast, just send me a signal. God is so good. God is so good. Yes, Marcus, God bless you. Aaron, God bless you. And anybody I miss, God bless you. So stay strong. Don't compromise the values that are written in the Bible. Those are your values. That's your roadmap. No matter what it looks like, keep going. If God has given you something to do, don't give up. Don't doubt. Keep the faith. Stay strong. Stay focused. Stay encouraged. Believe and receive that it is so. It is written, God will never leave you or forsake you. So yes, those of you that have just joined, share the broadcast, share it in your groups, share with your friends. And I'm taking prayer requests during the broadcast. You can type those in. Yes, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Nope, I'm not going to compromise my values to get ahead. I work for the government. I know about compromises and politics and things such as that. Nope, I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to do it. I don't care what arena I'm in. If God didn't tell me to do it, I'm not going to do it because I don't want my eternal life to be compromised. This is a temporary realm that we're walking in. The natural realm, this will all fade away. You know, I want to hear God say, well done, my good and faithful servant. You know, I don't want God to say, depart, for I don't know you, and all those things, you know, that can happen. Yes. Yes. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Oh, yeah. Pump those hearts and likes so I can make sure everything is working. God bless you. So yes, in Colossians 3:2, it says, set your affection on things above, not on the things of the earth. You know, we don't set our things, our mind on the things of the earth. Those are fleeting. Those are fading. Those, you know, we leave with us. You know, you can accomplish so many things on this life, in this life, but in the end, you leave it. You don't, it doesn't come with you. You go on your own, just naked as I came, naked as I will depart. You know what I'm saying? So everything that you accumulate, whether it's positions, money, fame, whatever, material things, those things you leave. So, you know, that's just here for this natural realm. Even this human body is just here for this earth, you know? So yes, yes. Oh, you shared Brittany. You shared Brittany. God bless you. 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 Yes. Glory to God. Glory to Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I'm just so excited. Continue to type in your prayer requests and share the broadcast. Share the grace, everybody. Oh, God is so good. God is so good. Thandy, I was going to try to put you on the broadcast. Not sure if it's going to go through. You know how this internet is, I'm telling you. But I'm going to keep on with the things of God. Yes, yes, I'm going to keep on with the things of God. So in 1 John 1:9, it says, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. If we confess it, you know, God is our friend, so we can do all that for him, to him. You know, let him know, God, I'm struggling in this area in my mind. There's a stronghold in my mind. God, I keep getting depressed. I know you got all these blessings in store for me, God. God, you know, I keep letting the enemy talk to me, and it gets me distracted from my calling or my purpose, and I go in the opposite direction. You know, all these things we can confess to God, you know, and we can ask him for forgiveness. You know, at the same time, we know we're forgiven, so God's not going to hold anything against us. You know, if you're struggling, you know, in the area of pornography, if you're struggling in the area of, you know, different things that you know that you're not supposed to be doing as a Christian, you know, if you're being mean to people, if you're trying to block people out of opportunities due to selfish ambitions, you know, you can confess all that to God. Those are all strongholds. You know, that's just fear. That the devil's like, if I push them, you know, push them out the way, then you don't have to worry about, you know, losing your position or you know, what people are going to say about you. You know, we worry so much, and I'm, you know, oh yeah, God bless you. Thank you for joining. Grace to you as well. You know, I've been guilty of people pleasing, wanting people to, you know, what do people think? And I want to look good in their sight. Now, all that, none of that matters. It's about what does the word of God say? God is not a respecter of person. He's not a man that he should lie. So he doesn't put people in certain groups and certain categories or try to take opportunities for people, you know, from people, or just want us to be selfish. He wants us, when we are lifted, to lift our brothers and sisters up. You know, it's not just about the opportunities that you will receive, but it's about how can you pull another person up along with you? God bless you. God bless you, Carrie. Yes, God bless you. Thank you so much. Yes, God bless you. Yes, thank you, everybody, for watching this broadcast. If I miss your name, just know I love you with the love of the Lord, and that you're blessed. You are definitely blessed. Amen. Blessings to you as well. Hey, share this broadcast with your friends. Share it in your groups. And I'm taking prayer requests during this broadcast. If you have that, if you want to be a part of the broadcast, just let me know. Just let me know. Yeah, but I'm saying it's about God. Yes, it's about God. More grace. Hallelujah. Thank you so much. More grace to you as well. It's about the works of the kingdom of God. It's about expanding the kingdom of God. See, that's where we're supposed to keep our minds on things like that. It's about discipleship. It's about whose life can you show through your actions that there's a better way, that Jesus is a personal savior, that they can have eternal life. You know, if they see that you're doing the things like the things of the world, they're not going to want to latch on to that. If they see that you're just functioning with selfish ambitions, they're not going to want to be a part of that. They're like, oh, I've seen that already. I know this system. I'm not seeing anything different. I'm not seeing any new things happen. So we have to, you know, when we renew our mind, we help others as well, because it's not about us, but it's about the expansion of the kingdom of God. God bless you. Yes, I'm just letting the Holy Ghost flow. It's about God. You know, we get so bound by, you know, the things we've learned in this life and the systems and everything that we're like, I'm not going to be able to do this, God, because all these things are against me, God. You know, sometimes I'll go through that. You know, I'm a woman. I'm in ministry. Yeah, I'm a prophetess. You know what I'm saying? All these things that sometimes work against you in different systems. It shouldn't. But, you know, that's the reality of this life. If you're dealing with people that haven't renewed their minds, you know, they're going to use those same systems regardless of what arena you're in. So it's important. It helps others. Yes, Maurice, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you so much. God bless you. God bless you. I'm trying to see if this camera feature is working. So God bless you. So I'm here praying for everybody, reading the word of God and talking about what thus saith the Lord. Yes, God is so good. God is so good. In 1 John 4:14, it says, ye are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than is in the world. You know, so we got the greater. We're supposed to show the greater. We are the greater. We'll be the greater. Our mind is greater. Everything about us is greater. So we don't need to function in that low level kingdom of darkness, those systems. And we're supposed to rise above everything that we're taught in this life and read that word. That's what we're supposed to be thinking on. All thinking on good things, thinking on things above, not beneath, not on the things of beneath. You know, the things beneath are doubt. The things beneath are fear. You know what I mean? The things beneath are racism. You know, God created us all the same. Any ism, schism, all of that, you know? Yes, yes, the word of God is power. Amen. Yeah, glory, glory, glory to God. That's what I'm here for, is to give glory to God. You know, I've spent enough of my life giving glory to myself, other human beings, you know, putting them on a pedestal. You know, we can't even hardly trust ourselves to do the things that we say that we're going to do. So, you know, why, you know, trust man, you got to trust God. That's really the only thing in the end you can do, is trust God and the word, trust his word, and pray and commune, spend time communing with God. That's how we renew our minds. We have to renew, we have to die to self daily. Really, it's more like every moment, but I say daily, you know, and read that word. And if you see areas you're having difficulty in, pray to God, ask for forgiveness, repent. Don't stay the same. Think that God's not seeing it. Okay, I can hide this. you know, then you're not maturing. You're not maturing as a Christian if you're still staying at that low level, dealing with those things that you learned in this life, dealing with the systems of this life, you know? So that can weigh you down. That weighs others down. So yes, God is so good. God is so good. I love the things of the Spirit. It's lifting. It opens the door to say, yes, I can. Yes. Oh, yes, I can. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Oh, I'm more than a conqueror through Christ Jesus. Yes, no weapon that's formed against me shall prosper. I'm the head. I'm not the tail. I'm above. I'm not beneath. You know, all those things, we have to renew our mind. That's how we cleanse our mind and stay strong. And that's how we deliver, how we become delivered, not just Christians and accepting Christ as our personal Savior, but being delivered, be delivered, you know, be delivered, be delivered. Let anything that's coming from the demonic realm, let it be removed. Anything that's hampering our minds, let it be removed. Let the Holy Ghost fire penetrate it and burn it. Burn it, God. Burn it, God. Let your will be done. Your will, your way, your time. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, yes. Repent. Repent. Oh, God. Yeah, you can't repent enough. We can't repent enough. That's right. We can't repent enough. You know, and continue, guys, share the broadcast. Hey, let me know when you've shared. Share it with your friends. Share it in your groups. Prophetess Debbie Wilson here. Sanctuary of Love International Ministries is my 501c3 organization. It's a ministry, you know, that I'm starting. It's about a year old, you know, now. And so if you want to sow a seed, you can do that too. But, you know, partner with the ministry, with your prayers and just, you know, anything, any skills that you have, you know, oh, just like I said, we're to pull each other up. If you've got it made and you got some advice or you got some way you can help somebody, help one another on the path. Don't just say, oh, I got mine. No, that's what we used to say in the world. Oh, I got mine. You get yours and all that. Come on, we gotta rise above. It's not about us. It's about expanding the kingdom of God. You know, yes, yes, I could pray for your sister, Claudia. Yes, yes, oh, yes. If you can try to send me a signal, because when I try to bring people, if you want to come on camera, it's not coming through. It could just be my internet broadcast. But God, right now, yes, I'm praying, God, for Claudia, God, you know what the need is, God. You know what the need is, God. God, make a way, God. Make a way for them, God. And Marie, yes, if you can type that in, if you have a specific request, we know that you want her to live a life of abundance. And God, you know, we know that you want us to be healthy, whole, renewed, restored, and revived, God. Send your Holy Ghost fire. Send your Holy Ghost fire to them and heal in the areas that's needed, God. Oh, God bless you. Hey, Tony. Yes, God bless you. Thank you for joining the broadcast. Hey, as you come on, share this broadcast. I'm praying. I'm reading the word of God and just talking about the strongholds of the mind today. God bless you. Thank you, Tony, for joining. And once you've shared the broadcast, let me know. If you'd like to join the broadcast, let me know. I've been trying to get people to join, and it hasn't been going through. There's a couple people that sent me a message to go to try to come on camera, and it hasn't been going through. So, but you're welcome. We'll just keep going. When I come on these broadcasts, you know, technology, it does all kinds of things. I'm just prepared to do what thus saith the Lord. Amen. Oh, you shared. Oh, Claudia, God bless you. Claudia, I'm going to see. I don't even see that you're on. Send me a signal if you want to be a part of the broadcast, and I will definitely pray for you. And also, guys, via Facebook Messenger, you can always type in your prayer requests to me, and I do pray and follow up on those. But if you want me to contact you further than that, Just send me a message and I will definitely get back with you via Messenger. I will call via Messenger. You know, you have to be very careful too with technology and you know, there's a lot of things going on. So yeah, so God is good. God is good. Thank you all for joining us, Sharon. So I just want to read, when I come on, I try to make sure I'm reading the Word of God, talking about life, taking your prayer requests and just going on in the things of God. So like in 1 Timothy 1:7, it says, "For God has not given us the spirit of fear." He hasn't given us that. "But of power and of love and of a sound mind." You know, so we can't give in to our fears. That's another stronghold of the mind. You know, the enemy tries to come in and fear and put fear in our mind. If you don't do this, this ain't going to happen. Or if you don't do it in this way, God's not going to bless you. Or if you don't do this for this person, you won't move up any further. And all kinds of fears the enemy tries to put in our mind. But fear is not from God. He did not give us the spirit of fear. He gave us power. He gave us a sound mind. So that's what we always have to remember. God is so good. Oh, yes, yes. We have to obey in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, yes. Oh, thank you for sharing, Tandy. Tandy, God bless you. God bless you so much. Yes, yeah, so we cannot fear. We got to be courageous. That means we got to step out on faith. And it may look shaky. It may look, that ground might not look solid or the water moving and everything else. But we got to step out on faith. That's how we gain our freedom. That's how we got to push back. You know, we got to put the enemy under our feet. He's given us the power to tread upon serpents. Anything that's not of God, that's what we need to be coming against. Not the people of God, not people that you see that are trying to do the best that they can. A lot of times we do so much to each other that we know it's not of God. You know, we criticize each other or we, "Oh, that was okay, but they could have done this a little bit better." You know, all kinds of things are happening in this life. And we're supposed to boost each other up. Oh, go. I like to see people go forth or to progress. I say, now, if God did it for them, I know he'll do it for me. So I like to be, you know, I like to see people blessed. I mean, I love to see people blessed. God's like, okay, that's possible then, you know. It's a blessing to see things happen in the natural realm. Yeah, so God is so good. God is so good. Connect, connect, connect. Share the grace. Share the broadcast. Oh, this is just the Holy Ghost flowing, you know, from within me. You know what I mean? And just, I'm a minister of the gospel. I'm just flowing in the prophetic. You know, is the office that I'm in, but I have other giftings of teaching, intercession, and things such as that. So if you see God going forth in a way that doesn't look like it's different to you, or that it may not be traditional, doesn't mean that it's wrong or that it's not correct. It's just God using who he wants to use in a way that he wants to use them to get to the people that he knows that need the message. It's not anything wrong with it. So we've got to open up our minds. God bless you. God bless you, Fabian. Yes. Cabela, God bless you. Yes. So God is a creative God. Just think about it. He created each and every one of us for a purpose, for a plan. So part of renewing our mind is opening up our mind. Some of us have a closed mind. We're religious instead of spiritual. It's about opening up your mind to the things of God. How are you going to receive the blessings of God if you have a closed mind? You won't know when the blessing comes because you'll be looking at it negatively and saying, this didn't come in a way we got to take hold when the Holy Spirit is flowing. You got to take hold of it. Then it's quick. And you know, that fire is burning. You gotta latch on and, you know, be a part of it. You can't sit back and say, if it come this way, God, I'll take it. God, if it, you know, if I hear the right word, God, give me confirmation. It doesn't always work like that. God is a creative God. He uses who he wants to use, how he wants to use them, and when he wants to use them. God is so good. Oh, share. God, I'm just so excited, you guys. I'm just excited. You know, I love the Holy Ghost. I'm a God's girl. I love the things of God. And, you know, however he wants to use me, that's what I want to do. But, you know, it's about renewing my mind daily, because emotionally, sometimes I'm like, I don't feel like it today, God, or I'm distracted. I'm looking at what other people are doing instead of looking at what God, what is it that you would have for me to do, God? You know, all those kind of things are, you know, we shouldn't be judgmental. We got to renew our mind as well to not judge, because if we're judging people, you know, we don't want to be judged on those same standards. We want people to accept us. We want people to approve of us. We want people to love us. We want people to treat us kindly, all those things. Well, you know, do that to other people as well, you know? So God is so good. Yes. Thank you so much for joining. Yes, Marcin. Thank you. Holy Ghost, Spirit, super awesome. Yeah, that's the Holy Ghost. It's not about me. It's just about the Holy Ghost wanting to come forth and deliver a message to you to you know, keep a sound mind and to come against those strongholds that are in our mind. It's not our fault. It's how we were taught, or how the culture. Well, and then media has a lot to do with what we think as well. But we got to come against those things. Yes, we got to come against it. So I'm taking prayer requests as well, guys. So, and continue to share the broadcast. Yes. You know, I'm my spiritual father, but you will have to probably catch the next one. My spiritual father is Prophet Jack Shekinah Glory. He has a deliverance class going on, 3-day class. We've had two days of it. And so it's just been an awesome class. So if you have the opportunity to participate in a deliverance class, although they're just awesome. It takes you beyond, anything you've done before, as far as even, because as Christians, we need to be delivered from a number of things. Yes. So in Philippians 4:8, it says, finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, it says, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, it says, if there be any virtue and if there be any praise, think on these things. We're supposed to be thinking of good things, not negative things, you know, not scandalous things, not things that are, like I said, are beneath us. You know, we've been given the knowledge. We have knowledge. And if we don't know, you know, my spiritual father, Jack Shekinah Glory, was telling us in class about the, you know, the devil uses ignorance. That's how he keeps our minds, keeps strongholds on our minds. You know, it's through ignorance. You know, but within the Bible, we have all kinds of knowledge to go to. There's no excuse to be ignorant, you know, in the kingdom, outside of the kingdom. But, you know, that's the devil's going to use that against you. I can get in there. They don't have enough knowledge about what thus saith the Lord. So let me get in their head and twist it around a little bit and put some doubt in there. God bless you as well, Claudia. God bless you. Yeah, so that's what the devil does. So we have to be mindful of the schemes and tricks of the enemy. God is so good. Yes, you know, we always have to think on the word of God. You know, it's like my pastor, Pastor Herbert Banks, says the word will work for you. I believe that. You know, it takes time to understand that. But every time I read the word, I gain more knowledge. I gain more insight. I gain more strength. You know, so that when the devil comes to me for certain things, I can say, no, that's not in the word. That's not God. That's another voice. That's not the voice of God. You know, but you know, it's a process, like I said. Yeah, amen. It's a process. So we got to gain knowledge. We got to gain knowledge and continue to renew our minds and open our minds. You know what I'm saying? Don't, but close the doors to the satanic realm, to the devil. Those doors that you know are going to lead you into, you know, like character, different things in our character that's going to lead us to certain behaviors. You know, we just got to admit we got them. It's not a big deal. God knows, you know, go to him and repent and God help me work on this. You know what I'm saying? But it's a process. It's a process, you know, but keep your mind encouraged. Keep your mind encouraged. Praise God. Listen to music. Listen, you know, keep your mind encouraged so that you can be rise above the things of this life. Knowing that God has given you everything that you need to bring his plan to fruition, to completion, so that you can have eternal life. Yes. So be positive. Be positive. Yes. Yes. Love your enemy. And that's what I'm saying. Love everybody. Bring somebody else along. Show them the way. Show them your light. Let your light shine so that they can see that there's something better. You know, and on this Christian walk, you know, you're going to have to take some risks, though. You can't stay in the world that you came from, in the standards of that world that you came from, in the behaviors of that world that you came from, bringing the character from that world that you came from. We've been given eternal life. We've been born again. We got to let the things go, you know, that we learned in this world, the secular world or things of this world. We got to let it go and let God renew a right mind in you. Let him give you more strength. Let him remove doubt. Let him remove fear. Let him show you his way, because it's not our will, but it's about the will of God. Yes. Yes. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, everybody, for being a part of this broadcast. And if you catch this broadcast on replay, just know that you're blessed. Yes, you're blessed. And continue to share this broadcast. Share this broadcast. Even if you get on it where it's not live, share the broadcast, because I believe what God has told me. Somebody needs to hear this word. We've got to break these strongholds of our mind so that we can mature as Christians, and we can mature just as people, and that we don't have to hide anything from God. If you've got some issues in there that still need to be cleansed, just pray to God. Read his word. I'm telling you, any negative thing that's in there, you read the word of God enough, it's coming out of there. Because the satanic realm doesn't want to be in something that's filled with light. That's one thing that God is showing me. Even this goes for health conditions. This goes for mental conditions. I mean, depression, anxiety, anything that's like that. It doesn't like light. It wants to hang out in the darkness. So the more that you fill your mind and your body with light, the satanic realm, the devil doesn't like that environment. He doesn't want to be bothered with all that light and all that stuff. Yes, God bless you. God bless you, Isaac. Thank you so much for joining the broadcast. I've been talking about strongholds of the mind and how to renew your mind. You know what, with reading the word of God, you might have to catch it on replay. And just talking about life, I'm also taking prayer requests. So if you have a prayer request before I leave the broadcast, let me know. I'm just flowing in the things of God. Prophetess Debbie Wilson here. I thank God for using me. You know, I never imagined that I would be doing this, you know, but God, with God, all things are possible. You know, with God, if we humble ourselves, if we renew ourselves daily, if we die to ourselves daily and we read the word, we commune with God, we trust God, we step out on faith, we remove doubt and fear. And like I said, anything you've learned in this life, especially if you're going to be a mature Christian, try to remove that. Just repent to God. You know, if you're got a little bit of racism to you, or schisms, you know, some people have things against, women in ministry, or things, you know, just, just things, you know, in the way people look or the way they act. You know, we got all kind of little things we learn from this world. Clean those out. You want to let the light of the Holy Ghost fire flow within you. You want to close the door to the demonic realm. Any door that you leave open, that's where the devil's coming. And even if you clean them out, he gonna look for another opening again to get back in there. You know, so you have to be, this is a process. This is a daily walk. This is something he will never give up. So you know you gotta be strong. But you know, you're wanting to be approved by God. So even though we're works in progress, if God is approving you, us, whatever, we're doing good. We're doing good. We're on the path. That's all. We're just, you know, we're on the path. So just be mindful of your thoughts and, you know, your actions, character, behavior, and, you know, just be delivered, be delivered, be delivered in the name of Jesus from the things that are not of God. Yes, God is so good. God is so good. Thank you so much for joining the broadcast. God bless you so much. God bless you so much. Yes, just remember, Jesus is Lord. It's about pleasing God. Shalom. Goodbye. Goodbye. Bye for now. God bless you.